His thoughts there in the grain trade, Todd, appreciate that as always. Now turning to livestock, a lot of eyes wondering, okay, limit down yesterday, cattle and feeder cattle, follow through today, still a bit lower. We started out just a little bit higher, but your thoughts on the beef complex.
You know, I really think, Mark, we were watching 117 in the fats and the live cattle, and I said if we couldn't stay above it, we probably would break down, and now we're right back to that old support level. And interesting enough, we're getting a lot of volatility around this 113, 114 level. I'm looking to be a buyer down here. I think this is probably the low end of the range. We could see a little bit more puking coming out here, a little bit more fear, but overall, they had every chance to continue lower this morning and really didn't take them down quickly. In fact, tried to rally, so the natural move would be to sell them a little bit first, but I think you're probably somewhere near a base here, and I'm looking to be a buyer in this 113 to 114 range. What I want to see is I want to see it hold off here and stop the markets from going down, and once we kind of flatten out, it'll make me much more interested to be a buyer, but I am bullish. I am looking for a spot to get in. It performed exactly what we were looking for at around 117, and the same goes for feeders, Mark. We were at that 145, 146 here. I said, we go below 145, 140 is in play. Where did we go? We went right to 140.
Yeah, yeah.
I think that 140 is probably a buy. Again, we don't want to try to catch the falling knife, especially farmers and producers, hoping you're protected here so you're not being affected. Actually, you're rolling down and taking some of the money out of the market. But if you're looking to trade here, this is probably an area you want to look at, but you want to wait. We want to see some buyers step in a little bit. We don't want to push them right back up. That's not good action. We want to see some slow new money slowing and kind of flatten out the trend here. And once we can get that, then I would think it'd be safe to buy. And I think we go back to at least 145. But if we can get over 146, I think 152 comes back into play.
There you go. All right. And like you say, limit up. As a producer, they'd want to see that. But you're saying that's not healthy for the market as a trader looking at it from your vantage point.
It's really not healthy for anybody, Mark, because if it goes limit up, first of all, if we're not selling it today, which most of us aren't, it's hard. You're not getting out. So it really creates more of a meaning that we could probably go a lot lower, because those vicious moves are usually forcing the weak hands out of the market, mm-hmm. and then they're going to go back and resume that trend. So we want to see gentle new money coming in. We want to see nibbling coming in, because otherwise you end up with a market that probably will have more room to go on the downside.
Well, maybe nibbling at the live hog, lean hog complex here a little bit at those highs we saw there, 88.12 on the August here, but hogs can, you know, holding in today. Your thoughts there?
I think they're holding in, but I noted something interesting over the weekend that, you know, we've only really seen real action in the August hogs, and everywhere else has been fairly stagnant. Yeah. And I think that's really a more of a warning sign that there's probably some trouble brewing. And, you know, I think the cheaper cattle gets, it makes hogs a little bit less attractive. So I think overall, if we can hold up here, I would not mind it. I like them, but I don't love them here. I think that we've gotten a little bit over where we should be. And again, I'm concerned about the other action away from August. It hasn't been real attractive, so I'm a little bit concerned, not bearish, but still not really overly like want to jump in and buy them here either.
Yeah, big break there from the August to the October contract, and the hogs that we see pretty obvious. All right, Todd, thanks for the time as always. I think you're back tomorrow, and we're glad you are.
Thanks, Mark.
Talk to you then. Todd Horwitz, Bubba Trading. It's BubbaTrading.com. One of that website. A lot of great information there. Buying or selling. Just getting you, again, managing that risk. And that's what it's all about, Janet.
All right.